Yo, what's up? I'm Marthe from Galena Cube, and I'm really excited today because I'm going to talk to you about translytical task flows. And it's really going to change the game of Power BI and how we use it, because Power BI up until this point has been this place you pull all that data into the reports, and then people can take information and insights and make decisions based on all of that. But with translytical task flows, now you can suddenly, as the reader of the report, provide feedback back to the underlying data set. So you can actually edit the data, delete it, insert new records, and also call API calls. What? So it's just gonna help us distribute responsibility, distribute tasks more easily, and you don't have to go to a data engineer to have something updated or changed. It could just happen right there. But you know what? Enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. So the very first thing you have to do inside of Fabric is to actually, inside of the admin portal, enable both the SQL database and the user data functions that we want to take advantage of. Now you go into a workspace of your choice. Maybe you can create a new one or just use one that you already have. And the first thing we have to do is actually pull in some sample data from AdventureWorks, and it's sales data essentially, that I want to see if I can, inside of my Power BI report, update the list prices for the different products directly. And then it's going to update beautifully in the background of the actual underlying data. First of all, we need the data. So let's create a new SQL database. We're gonna give it a great name. Now the Fabric user data function also support connection towards Fabric Warehouse and a Lakehouse and a Merit database. But we're using a SQL database now because that's ideal for heavy read-write operations. We're just gonna actually choose sample data. The data that's gonna be pulled in here is the actual AdventureWorks sample data that I just talked about. And now we see here we have sales, LT, as some data that's now appearing here. And if I open up the product table, I want to show you the data that I want us to play around with today. So we have product ID, we have names of the different products, and we also have the list price of the different products. Now this is the price that I want to update directly from Power BI. Cool, okay, so now we have the data ready in our SQL database. The next thing we're gonna do is to actually set up a user-defined function. And you do that in the same way, go to new item, user-defined function, and you just create a new one and give it a great name. Now I've already done this, so I'm gonna open up one that I just created for us. The first time when you open up a user-defined function, you're gonna have a sample code here ready for you to use. And the first thing you have to do is to actually manage the connection. So what is the connection you want this user-defined function to work towards? So we're gonna go in here, go to connections, and then I've already created a connection, but you can then add the data connection. Then you're gonna choose the SQL database that you want it to work towards. So just choose that SQL database you just created, but you also see here that you could have chosen existing lakehouses or warehouses or mirror databases if you had any of those. Now you need to give it a good name. So make sure that this name is something you remember. So copy that. And then you see here that I've written this code. So I'm going to go through this together with you now. So the first thing we're doing is to set up the alias towards the actual connection of the underlying data. So this is where you put in the name of the connection that we just created. So that for us was AdventureWorks LT. And then we're going to define a function that I'm going to call update list price, which you see here is also ready for us to use here, with input of the list price and the product ID of whatever I want to update the price on. Then I'm going to put in some logging information, and I'm going to connect to the actual SQL database. And this right here is the actual code that is helping me update that list price. So here I could, of course, have had insert instead, or maybe delete, whatever you want this to be. And then when everything is done, I want it to return that new price was successfully added. Then we can test it to see if it works. So I'm just gonna play around here and see. Woohoo, it works. And then when we're ready, we can then publish this user data function. So now we have our underlying SQL database, and we also have the user defined function with the logic that is actually gonna update the rows that we want inside of our product table. Now we need a user interface where we can actually provide that input. And we do that inside of Power BI, of course. So let's open up our blank Power BI page. And the first thing you have to do here, if you haven't already, is to enable the option of translytical task flows. So if you go into the preview features, you have to make sure that you have enabled translytical task flow, connect to Fabric SQL databases, and also the text slicer visual, because that's what we're going to use today. Then we're going to start by connecting to our existing SQL database. So this one, connect. And this is the product table that I want to play around with. So I'm going to choose that one, click load. And then here, this is most important. So when you're prompted, do you want to do import or direct query? You want to do direct query because that means when you're making a change in Power BI, it's going to connect live to the data source and then change that data source. So it's going to happen instantly. So that's what we want. So I'm going to choose direct query. Okay, so let's just start by pulling out the data that we want to pay attention to. So that's product ID, list price. And let's also pull in the name so we understand what we're looking at. I don't want to summarize these. I just want to see them. And I also wanted to pull in this text slicer here. So this is where we're going to write the actual updated list price directly. Then we also need a button. So let's choose a blank button. Let's pull this below here. And then we need to activate some actions on this. So the action we want to choose here is the data function. So we're going to choose that. The workspace is my AdventureWorks workspace. And I want to use the update list price function. That's the one that we just created together. And the data function should be update list price. Now we see that we have two items here that we want to take advantage of. We have list price and the product ID. We have these fancy word names. Now, if I actually instead give this text box here a title, so let's say update list price. If I go back to my button now, you're going to see in the action, we can choose to put in the list price in this text box. So now that makes sense. That's where we want this information to come from. But the product ID, I want the product ID to be the product ID that I'm selecting from my other visual here. So if I choose this one, then I want 877, then this is the actual list price that I want to update. So if we then choose to set up a conditional formatting here instead, we want to use product ID. So now I'm using conditional formatting to choose the product ID that I want to update. So this is more interactive. So let's just see if this works. So we have now 877 marked here. So that's the ID. Let's update this to, what should we do? Oh, it's going to be a tiny bit more expensive, $7.99. Let's lock that in and then check this button. Boom! Okay, see, do you see that? Did you see that it was now automatically updated? But this was just in Power BI, and did it actually work behind the scenes inside of Fabric? So I'm going to open up my SQL database here. Then I'm going to run a query checking for that specific ID. 877. Let's run this. Yay! The list price now is 7.99. Okay, but let's sprinkle some magic here because this doesn't look cool at all. Boom! And now it looks a little bit better too. So now we have a report where someone can go in and update the list prices directly here from this Power BI report as a user interface. It's going to automatically update in the background. Now, this was a pretty simple example, but imagine you could have your managers comment directly on KPIs, for instance, directly inside of Power BI, and adding those comments into the underlying datasets, which means that you're suddenly going to have some semantics and some context to some of your data. And in the world of AI, yes, I know, I'm sorry, I'm mentioning it in every video. If you can do some Copilot stuff on top of that, who knows where you can end up. What do you think? Are you going to test this out? Let me know in the comments below. What else should we try out together? And of course, remember to subscribe to see where this journey leads and check out all the other videos from Adam, Patrick, and myself. And we will see you guys in the next video.